来看属灵的带领。
Today we are looking at the topic spiritual leadership.
上次我们也是在看属灵的带领，这一次我们要更加的比较简洁的来看属灵的带领到底是什么。
Last week the last time we looked at spiritual leadership as well. Today we will look at it in further depth.
首先，上次我们看过什么是属灵的带领，它是带动人要来跟从神的计划。
And the last time we asked the question, what is spiritual leadership? Spiritual leadership is moving people onto God's agenda.
这个世界都是非常的混乱。
This world is chaotic.
上一周在这个委内瑞拉就有这个总统的竞选，他们。大选了之后有暴动，因为双方都不承认，失败了。
Just this past week, protests in Venezuela after the results of the elections because both parties refused to accept the result of the election.
上一个月法国也是大选，之前所带领的政府也被推翻了。
And the same thing happened in France.
两个月前，英国大选同样的事情发生，之前带领的政府也被推翻了。
Two months ago, we saw the elections in the UK, and the same disputes happened.
在未来的几个月，我们知道美国的大选也要发生了，我们也不知道到时这个成绩到底是如何。
And soon we will see the results of the U.S. presidential elections and.We're not sure what the results will be.
所以这一个世界都是到处都在改变，这个带领的人都是在改变。
The world is constantly changing, and the people that lead this world are also constantly changing.
不过我们知道圣经给我们的教导，一个带领的人应该有什么样子的品格，应该有什么样子的责任，这个是对基督徒来说非常重要的。
But the Bible is clear as to what the characteristics and requirements of leadership are, and it's very important as Christians that we understand that.
所以我们今天会来看三点，就是带领人的委任、带领人的品格，还有带领人的模式。
So today we will be looking at three points: the leader's mandate, the leader's manner, and the leader's method.
首先，我们来看这个带领人的委任。
First, let's look at the leader's mandate.
我们要记得，所有的人都有一些带领的工作。
We must understand that every one of us has the responsibility, in some measure, to lead.
保罗在哥林多前书第十一章一节说：“你们该效法我，像我效法基督一样。”
Paul in 1 Corinthians 11 verse 1 said, "Be imitators of me." As I am of Christ.
保罗是使徒，他是其中一个最伟大的使徒。
Paul was an apostle, one of the greatest apostles.
可是他却说，你们要效法我，像我效法基督一样。所以保罗在带领人要跟随耶稣基督，要朝往神给他们的计划。
Yet even Paul himself said, follow me as I follow Christ. Paul had a leader and he was leading others towards Christ.
所以我们每一个人无论大小都是在做一些带领人的工作。
And so all of us, however great our responsibility, has a role in leading.
不过当然我们知道在教会神也设立了这个带领的人。
But we also understand that in the church, God has appointed leaders.
在以弗所书四章十一节，这里我们大家都很熟悉这一句话，就是神所赐的有使徒、有先知、有传福音的、有牧师和教师，为要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体。
We're all very familiar with this verse in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 and 12. And it says, "And he gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds and teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up of the body of Christ."
当然，今天教会已经没有使徒，已经没有先知了。不过有牧师和教师。
While we no longer have apostles and prophets in today's church, we still have shepherds and teachers.
使徒行传二十章二十八节，保罗在离开这个以弗所教会之前。 他把以弗所教会的这个长老招来了，告诉他们说，圣灵力你们做全群的监督，你们就当为自己谨慎，也为全群谨慎，牧养神的教会，就是他用自己的血所买来的。
In Acts 20:28, as Paul was about to leave the Ephesian church, he gathered its elders and he said to them, pay careful attention to yourselves and to all the flock in which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to care for the church of God, which he obtained with his own blood.
所以教会的长老是圣灵，也就是神所立的。
And so the church leadership is also one that is appointed by God.
提摩太前书五章十七节说，那善于管理教会的长老，当以为配受加倍的敬奉，那劳苦传道教导人的，更当如此。
In Paul's first letter to Timothy, chapter 5, verse 17, he says, let the elders who rule well be considered worthy of double honor, especially those who labor in preaching and teaching.
所以这里很清楚地告诉我们，教会的带领人就是长老，因为这个长老是要管理教会的。
The Bible is clear that the people who rule the church are its elders.
在彼得前书五章第一节到二节也是一样，这个是彼得所写的。彼得他是这个教会的长老，他就说，我这做长老，做基督受苦的见证，同享后来所要显现之荣耀的，劝你们中间与我们同做长老的人，务要牧养在你们中间神的群羊，按着神旨意照管他们。
In 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 1 to 2, it says, so I exhort the elders among you as a fellow elder and a witness of the sufferings of Christ, as well as a partaker in the glory that is going to be revealed, shepherd the flock of God that is among you, exercising oversight.
所以教会的带领人是神所设立的长老，这个是非常清楚的。
And so the church leadership is God'sAppointed elders.
在家里，神所设立的带领人就是丈夫。
In the home, God's appointed leader is the husband.
哥林多前书十一章三节，保罗这里写说：“我愿意你们知道，基督是个人的头，男人是女人的头，神是基督的头。”当然，中文这里翻译“男人是女人的头”，其实这一个。上下文让我们看见是讲丈夫是妻子的头，而不是所有的男人带领所有的女人。
Paul makes this clear in 1 Corinthians 11 verse 3. He says, but I want you to understand that the head of every man is Christ, the head of a wife is her husband, and the head of Christ is God.
所以很清楚的，在家中这个带领的人就是丈夫。
This makes it very clear that in the home, the leader is the husband.
当然这里所指的是信主的人，可是如果你的丈夫，如果你是姐妹，你的丈夫不信主的话怎么办呢？
This of course refers to people who are believers, but what about homes where sisters you have husbands that may not be believers?
这个是在其他的经文有教导姐妹应该如何对待不信主的丈夫。
And there are other parts of the Bible that teach women how to deal with husbandswho are non-believers.
我们今天就不谈这个话题。
Today we will not discuss that.
对所有的基督徒来说，神也是耶稣给我们大使命，叫我们要去使万民做我的门徒。
As for the rest of us as Christians, God has given us the great commission to make disciples of all nations.
如果你是家长，你有孩子的话，圣经教导家长必须要管教孩子，所以家长就是在带领孩子。
As parents, you have the responsibility of training up a child, and therefore you are the leader of the child.
箴言说，教养孩童使他走当行的道，就是到老他也不偏离。
Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, even when he is old, he will not depart from it.
所以家长正要带领孩子必须要行主的道。
And so for the parent to lead their child, they need to be living out God's word.
提多书告诉我们要劝老年妇人用善道教训人，好指教少年妇人，所以老年妇人要指教少年妇人。
Titus 2:3-5 says, women, older women, are to teach what is good, and so train the younger women.
所以所有的人都是有带领的工作。
And so you see, everyone has some responsibility in leadership.
可是神非常清楚地设立了这个带领人，在教会是长老，在家中是丈夫。
And it's very clear that God has appointed specific roles to lead. In the church, it's the elder. At home, it is the husband.
每个人都有带领的工作，可是我们是否是一个好的带领人，还是一个不好的带领人？
And while everyone has a responsibility to lead, the question is, are you a good leader or a not good leader?
所以我们首先看了这个带领人的委任，就是神所赐给教会的，就是长老，在家中就是丈夫。
And so that was point number one, the leader's mandate. And again, we said that the leader in the church is the elder, the leader at home is the husband.
我们现在来看带领人的品格是什么。
Let's look at the leader's manner.
首先，带领人必须是要一个谦卑的人。
First of all, the leader needs humility.
在圣经里，除了耶稣基督之外，应该没有任何另外一个人能够比摩西更加的谦卑。
In the Bible, other than Jesus, of course, there is probably no one else who compares to the humility of Moses.
摩西是以色列最伟大的带领人。
He is the greatest of Jewish leaders.
可是他是一个非常谦卑的人。民数记十二章三节说，摩西为人极其谦和，胜过世上的众人。
Yet he was a man of great humility, and Numbers 12:3 tells us that now the man Moses was very meek, more than all people who were on the face of the earth.
所以神所要的带领人，无论是长老也好，无论是丈夫也好，他必须是一个谦和谦卑的人。
And so the leader that God requires, whether it is in the home or in the church, is a man who is meek and humble.
腓立比书二章三节，凡事不可结党，不可贪图虚浮的荣耀，只要存心谦卑，个人看别人比自己强。这个是非常重要的教训，带领人必须是一个谦卑的人。
Philippians 2:3 underscores that need for humility. It says, do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves.
我们要怎么知道一个人是否是谦卑的人呢？
How do we know if someone is humble?
他需要是一个顺服长老的人，在教会里头。
He first needs to be someone who obeys his leaders in the church.
当然，如果是丈夫在家里，他应该顺服谁呢？
Of course, in the home setting, as the husband, the leader as the husband, who should he obey?
刚才我们已经看了，这个基督是个人的头，也就是说，丈夫在带领他的家庭的时候，他必须顺服基督。
We saw just now that Jesus is the head of man, and so in the home, the husband needs to be obeying Christ.
这个丈夫必须要顺服神的话。
He needs to be living according to God's word.
当然，长老在带领教会的时候，长老也必须要顺服主的话。
And it's the same for the elder who is leading the church. He needs to be obeying God's word.
这个所有的人都会同意。
And I think everyone can agree with this.
只不过在行为上，有很多人在行为上却不是表现顺服的这个功课。
However, in practice, not everyone is demonstrating this lesson of humility.
没有任何一个基督徒会告诉你说我不顺服神的话。
There is no Christian who will tell you, no, I don't obey God's word.
可是当他讲他顺服神的话的时候，他的言行举止到底有没有，是不是一致的呢？
But whenDoes this person's words match up with their actions?
他说他顺服神的话，可是他却不顺服长老。
He says he is obedient and humble, however he doesn't obey his elders.
他如果不顺服他的长老，他就不是一个谦卑的人。
And if he does not obey his leaders, then he is not a person who is humble.
亚里士多德说，没学会顺服的人不能成为好司令。
Aristotle himself said, "He who has never learned to obey cannot be a good commander."
要做一个好的带领人，首先自己必须要学会顺服其他的人。
For someone to become a good leader, they first need to know how to follow.
彼得前书五章五节非常清楚地告诉我们，年幼的要顺服年长的。这里的上下文也是指着长老，而不是指年长的人。就是你们众人也都要以谦卑束腰，彼此顺服。看到了吗？
1 Peter 5:5 says, likewise you who are younger be subject to the elders. And over here in the context, it's clear that it is the role of the leader.Clothe yourselves, all of you, with humility toward one another, for God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble.
神阻挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人，所以一个谦卑的人才是神所要的带领人。
God opposes the proud, but he gives grace to the humble, and humble is what God wants in a leader.
希伯来书十三章十七节，你们要依从那些引导你们的，且要顺服。
Hebrews 13:17, obey your leaders and submit to them.
所以在教会要顺服教会的长老是一个谦卑的这个举止。
So again, in the church setting, obedience to the elders is a demonstration of that humility.
今天早上林姐妹告诉我说，她最近认识了一个人，她只说她带领教会就是带领一小组人来听这个麦克阿瑟的这个从网上听麦克阿瑟的这个讲道。
Our sister Lin shared this morning that there is someone who is leading a group of people to listen to John MacArthur's messages online.
他称这个自己是带领人，他带领这一小组人。他说这个麦克阿瑟的牧师的这个讲道才是最好的，所以他就带领一小组人来听这个麦克阿瑟的讲道。
And he calls himself a leader, and he sees the value and the goodness of John MacArthur's messages, and so he leads them in listening to the messages.
可是这样是一个好的带领人吗？
But is this a good leader?
他没有顺服教会的长老，因为他根本就不在一个教会里面。
He is not obedient to the elders of a church because he's not even part of a church.
我不知道当他如果听麦克阿瑟牧师所讲的道讲到这里的时候，讲要顺服那些引导你们的，或者是要顺服教会的长老，他要怎样去解释那一段圣经。
And I wonder when he approaches a text like this, which tells us that we need to obey our leaders, our elders, how does he deal with that text?
当然我们要记得，我们顺服教会的长老是因为教会的长老他们设一个好的榜样，他们跟随基督，他们顺服神的话，我们就跟从他，顺服他们。
Now, of course, the leaders in a church need to be following Jesus, and only then do we follow them.
这里不是说你盲目的跟从一个自称是长老的人。
It doesn't mean that you blindly follow anyone who claims to be a leader.
是的，所有的人都是在新约里，所有的信徒都是祭司。
Yes, in the New Testament, we are told that everyone, every Christian is a priest.
所有的基督徒都是圣洁的，因为耶稣基督的宝血洗净了我们。
Everyone is holy because the blood of Christ has cleansed us.
不过却有一些基督徒说，哦，既然所有的人都是祭司，所有的都是因着耶稣基督的宝血洗净了我们，所以我们不需要顺服任何人，我只需要顺服基督。
And so some might draw the conclusion that, well, since I'm holy, since I'm a priest and I've been cleansed by the blood of Christ, then I don't need to follow anyone, I only follow Jesus.
这一种说法是完全不符合圣经的。
Such a saying is completely disobedient to the Bible.
其实在旧约里也有这样的说法，也有一群人有这样的说法。
In fact, you will see this same claim in the Old Testament.
在民数记十六章三节，有一组人，他们就是可拉的这子孙，可拉还有他的弟兄，他们聚集攻击摩西亚伦，说你们擅自专权，全会众个个祭祀圣洁，耶和华也在他们中间，你们为什么至高超过耶和华的会众呢？
In Numbers 16:3, a group called the sons of Korah.They assembled themselves together against Moses and said, and against Aaron, and said to them, "You have gone too far, for all in the congregation are holy, every one of them, and the Lord is among them. Why then do you exalt yourself above the assembly of the Lord?"
神就审判了这群人。
God then judged this group of people.
地裂开了，把他们都给活活的吞吃了。
And the earth split apart and swallowed them alive.
所以神会审判那些不顺服他所设立带领人。
And so God will judge those who do not, the leaders who do not obey him.
在教会要怎样知道一个人是否是谦卑的，他必须要顺服他的长老。
So in the church, how do we identify humility? It is someone who obeys his leaders.
其实在家庭生活中也是一样，假如我们虽然如果我们是丈夫的话，有很多时候我们也不懂得怎么去的做决定，我们也是找教会的长老来给我们这个提议，或者是给我们劝告。
And this can be applied in the home as well. Oftentimes in our lives, in the home, we may not know how to make a decision. And often that requires us to come to our church leaders and ask for guidance and wisdom.
我们不要把教会与我们个人的生活给分开了。
We need to be careful not to split our private lives and our church lives.
我在教会我顺服长老，不过在家里我是王。
You might say, oh, in the church, only then do I obey my elders, but at home, I am king.
一个谦卑的人也必须是一个愿意受教的人。
A humble person is also one who is teachable.
再次的，怎样愿意受教，不只是在教会里的这个场合，而是在你一生人的场合。
And teachability is not just within the confines of the church and the Bible, but it is across your entire life.
在箴言十九章二十节告诉我们，你要听劝教，受训诲，使你终究有智慧。
Proverbs 19:20 tells us, listen to advice and accept instruction that you may gain wisdom in the future.
所以我们要看一个带领人是否是一个谦卑的人。如果他是一个谦卑的人，我们应该跟从他学习基督的样式。
And so we need to see if a person is humble, if our leaders are humble, and if they are, we need to follow their example.
如果你自己想要成为一个好的带领人，你也必须是一个谦卑的人。
If you yourself want to be a good leader, you need to be humble.
第二就是要做一个正直的人，这个是带领人的品格。
The second characteristic of a good leader is integrity.
箴言十章九节说，行正直路的步步安稳，走弯曲道的必致败路。
Proverbs 10:9 tells us, whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but he who makes his ways crooked will be found out.
这个就是指我们的言行举止，无论是向外还是没有人在看的时候，必须是一致的。
And this tells us that whether it isWhen others are watching us, or when in our private moments, do we continue to walk in a straight path?
你在家里，或者是在工作场所，或者是在教会，或者是在公众场所的时候，是不是完全不同的一个人？
Are you a completely different person in the different spheres of your life? Maybe you are a different person at work compared to church or at home.
我认识一个人，他在服侍的这个岗位，他的工作是一个服侍的岗位，在他服侍的岗位的时候，他讲话等等都是非常的怎么讲非常的柔和，因为他在服侍嘛，可是在家中却是一个乱发脾气的人。
I know someone whose job is in ministry and in his role
service.
And in his role, in his service role actually, he is constantly gentle and kind, but at home, he has a big temper.
这个就不是一个行为正直的人。
And this is a person who doesn't walk in integrity.
刚才我们说了，保罗自己讲，你们该效法我，像我效法基督一样。能够这么讲的，就是说他言行举止是一致的，因为周围的人都知道他的生命是怎样活的。
We said just now that Paul said in 1 Corinthians 11:1 to be imitators of me as I am of Christ. And this requires the integrity because everyone watches him and everyone knows how he lives.
腓立比书三章十七节也是说，弟兄们，你们要一同效法我，也当留意看那些照我们榜样行的人。
Philippians 3:17, brothers, join in imitating me and keep your eyes on those who walk according to the example you have in us.
所以带领人的品格必须首先是谦卑的, 第二是正直, 第三要有勇气。
The leader needs to have humility, integrity, and number three, courage.
需要有勇气做什么? 怎么表现他有勇气呢?
Why does he need courage and how does he demonstrate this courage?
他首先必须要坚守真道。
He needs to be someone who defends the truth.
提多书第一章九节, 这里保罗是在教导提多要如何设立长老, 长老应该有什么样子的品格。
In Titus 1:9, as Paul is teaching Titus what kinds of characteristics elders are called to and what and how to establish them.
所以就是要是一个坚守所教真实的道理, 就能将纯正的教训劝化人,又能把争辩的人驳倒了。
Paul says he being a leader must hold firm to the trustworthy word as taught, so that he may be able to give instruction in sound doctrine and also to rebuke those who contradict it.
所以一个带领的人必须要有勇气去坚守真道。
The leader needs to have courage to defend the truth.
他也必须要有勇气去使人归正。
He also needs courage to correct sinners.
在教会其实如果长老要去使人归正是一个非常难做的事情。
In the church, this is a very challenging task.
刚才我们都说了,教会一个好的带领人,无论你在哪里都必须要有愿意受教的心。
We said just now that a good leader needs to have a teachable heart.
往往在教会带领人,或者是长老去使人归正的时候,指出他的错误的时候,很多人就因此不高兴就离开教会了。
And it's not uncommon that church leaders or elders, when they have the courage to correct sinners, people get upset and leave the church.
所以因着许多人因着这样离开教会，教会的长老也不敢去告诉那些人，或者是现在在做的，教会的长老也不敢来告诉你说，哎，你的生命可能有一些问题啊，你要纠正。 完全不敢做，为什么? 担心伤害你, 担心你会因此生气就离开教会。
And over time, when people leave the church, when they receive correction, the elders and the leaders of the church become fearful of giving that correction because they are afraid these people will up and leave.
当然在纠正别人的错误的时候, 圣经告诉我们, 你们属灵的人就当用温柔的心把它挽回过来。
However, that correction has caveats, and in the Bible, Galatians 6:1 tells us that you who are spiritual should restore him, a brother in sin, in a spirit of gentleness.
教会的长老要做这种工作，需要会众。 有这个受教的心，有这个谦卑的心。如果你们自己想要做一个好的带领人，首先你就必须要谦卑，也必须要愿意受教。If
you are to be a good leader, you first need to be humble and will be willing to be taught.
谦卑正直还有勇气，他怎样表现他的勇气？要坚守真道，要使人归正。当然，最重要的，他愿意传福音。The
leader needs courage in defending the truth, in correcting sinners, and also in sharing the gospel.
彼得前书3:15节说：“只要心里尊主基督为圣，有人问你们心中盼望的缘由，就要常做准备，以温柔敬畏的心回答个人。”
Peter says in 1 Peter 3:15, but in your hearts, honor Christ the Lord as holy, always being prepared to make a defense to anyone who asks you for a reason for the hope that is in you, yet do it with gentleness and respect.
耶稣基督给所有的基督徒给了我们有大使命，必须要去使万民做他的门徒。
Jesus has given every Christian the great commission to make disciples of nations.
在我们牧师讲解希伯来书的时候，告诉我们，原来希伯来书那里的信徒收信的人，他们受了非常大的逼迫。
And as Pastor is going through the book of Hebrews with us, he tells us that the people who are being written to are also faced with great persecution.
彼得前书那里的信徒也是受到了大逼迫。
And it's the same situation that Peter's audience is facing.
保罗自己也受到了大逼迫。
Paul himself faced great persecution.
不过还是不断地传福音，而且鼓励信徒继续地传福音。
Yet he continues to share the gospel and encourages the Christians to fulfill the Great Commission.
你可以说那个是保罗，不是我。
But you can say, no, that's Paul, that's not me.
可是保罗说，你们要效法我。
But Paul says you must imitate me.
也就是说，也要效法他，有勇气去传福音。
And that means to imitate his courage to share the gospel.
今天我们担心被人拒绝，我们担心没有面子。
Today we are afraid of rejection. We are afraid of losing face.
我们完全没有勇气去传福音。
And we have lost all courage to share the gospel.
只是因为面子问题，或者担心被拒绝。
For the reason of rejection and face.
所以一个好的带领人必须要有勇气，勇气去传福音，勇气去使人归正。
And that is why it is so important for the leader to have courage, the courage to correct others.
最后，让我们来看这个带领人的模式。
Finally, let's look at the leader's method.
带领人要做些什么？
What must the leader do?
首先，当然带领人必须要祷告。First
of all, the leader needs to be praying.
他不能够靠自己的这个力量，他必须要靠主赐给他的力量。The
leader cannot be relying on his own strength. He needs to be relying on God's strength.
在但以理书6章9节到10节这里说，于是。 大利乌王立这禁令加盖玉玺，这个禁令是什么？如果你读上下文的话，是指他这个禁令就是禁止所有的人不能够敬拜任何的神，只能够敬拜他们的神。所以当这个禁令发了之后，但以理知道这禁令盖了玉玺，怎么做呢？就到自己家里，他楼上的窗户开向耶路撒冷，一日三次，双膝。
Daniel 6:9-10 tells us, Therefore King Darius signed the document and injunction. This injunction was to ban anyone from worshipping any other god but their god. And when Daniel knew that the document had been signed, he went to his house where he had windows in his upper chamber open towards Jerusalem. He got down on his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as he had done previously.
所以但以理这里给我们设立了一个非常好的榜样，就算是这个情况非常危急的时候，他还是祷告。This
is a great example that Daniel has left us, and even in the most, in the gravest of situations, he gets down on his knees and he prays to God.
当然我们知道这个后果是什么，因为他祷告他的神。 结果被丢进这个狮子坑里。We
of course know the outcome of Daniel's actions. Daniel was thrown into the lion's den.
当然神保守了他。But
of course we know also that God protected him.
带领人的模式首先必须要祷告，他不能够靠自己的力量，他必须要靠神给他的力量。第二，一个好的带领人必须要管理好自己的家。
The leader's manner is to pray. The leader's manner is also to manage his household.
当然，这里所指的是指弟兄。
Of course, over here it means brothers.
可是，如果你是姐妹的话，无论你是已婚或者你未婚，你如果是还没有结婚，你能够因着这一些去寻找一个好的伴侣，一个属神属灵的伴侣，你也能够知道应该怎样去，怎样去找。
This is not just relevant for sisters who are married, obviously. For our single sisters, this is a guide for you to find a man who is a good leader.
所以一个好的带领人必须要管理自己的家，这个是提摩太前书3章告诉我们的。
A good leader manages his household well, and this is what 1 Timothy 3:4 tells us.
教会的长老需要有的，这个就是要好好管理自己的家，使儿女凡事端庄顺服。
The elder, the church leader, must manage his household well, with all dignity, keeping his children submissive.
你可以说，哦，这个不关我的事，这个是指教会的长老，我不是长老，我不需要这么做。
But you might say, oh, this has got nothing to do with me. This is just for church leaders and elders.
不过我们要记得，全本圣经没有说分这一节经文是给长老的，这一节经文是给平信徒的，没有这样的分法的。
But we must remember that the Bible doesn't keep certain teachings that are exclusive to leaders or certain teachings that are exclusive to non-leaders.
记得保罗说，你们要效法我，像我效法基督一样。
Paul, remember, said that you must imitate me as I imitate Christ.
所以当保罗说教会的长老应该有这样的品格，也是指着其他的人都要跟从这样的品格。
And so when he says that the church elder needs to have a certain characteristic, he also means that the rest of the church needs to be following the leader's actions.
以弗所书六章四节说，你们做父亲的不要惹儿女的气，只要照着主的教训和警戒教养育他们。
Ephesians 6:4, Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord.
所以父母亲的这个责任非常的重大，他是做一个带领的人，要带领孩子顺服主，要怎样呢？要教训和警戒养育他们。
And so parents have a very important responsibility to lead their children, bringing them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord.
圣经给我们这一方面的教导是非常清楚的，在箴言29:15，杖打和责备能加增智慧，放纵的儿子使母亲羞愧。
The Bible is very clear about the role of parenting. Proverbs 29:15 adds on, "The rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself brings shame to his mother."
今天的社会告诉我们，有许多的心理学家等等的说，你不能够打孩子，你不能够教训他们，因为这样会使他们心灵创伤，以后就会变成一个大罪犯。
A lot of modern day psychologists tell us now that as parents,We cannot be firm with our children. We cannot discipline them because this will cause childhood trauma that's going to show up in negative ways in their adult lives.
可是圣经告诉我们要用杖打和责备。
But the Bible tells us that we are to use the rod and reproof.
如果你是听这个社会学还是你听圣经呢？
Are you listening to the world or are you listening to the Bible?
记得要做一个好的带领人，必须是一个谦卑而且愿意受教的人。
Remember that if you are to be a good leader, then you need to be humble and you need to be teachable.
如果你要做一个好的家长，带领你的孩子，你就必须要好好的顺服神的话。
If you are to be a good parent to bring your child up.In the fear and instruction of the Lord, then you need to be listening to the word of God.
不要用自己的智慧去行事。
Do not use your own wisdom.
不要用这一个世界告诉我们的这一些是属世的智慧。
Do not use the wisdom of the world.
在圣经里有许多非常出色的，而且是在侍奉神的，他们都在管教孩子方面失败了。
There are a lot of big names in the Bible that have failed in their roles as parents.
撒母耳记上告诉我们，以利就是当时的大祭司，他的两个儿子是恶人，不认识耶和华。
First Samuel tells us that Eli, who was the high priest, his children, his sons were worthless men. They did not know the Lord.
不认识耶，为什么呢？这个29告诉我们那个原因。
Verse 29 tells us why.
耶和华说：“我所吩咐现在我居所的祭物，你们为何践踏？尊重你的儿子过于尊重我，将我民以色列所献美好的祭物肥己呢？”所以以利这里犯了什么错误？他把自己的孩子看得比耶和华神更重要。
God says, Why then do you scorn my sacrifices and my offerings that I commanded for my dwelling, and honor your sons above me by fattening yourselves on the choicest parts of every offering of my people Israel? Eli's sin was to honor his sons above God.
他没有听从耶和华的道来教好好的管教他的孩子。
He did not follow God's word in parenting and disciplining his children.
他放纵他的孩子，任凭他们做什么都好。
And he allowed them to do whatever they wanted.
今天的这些社会学、心理学家就是告诉我们，你要让你的孩子自己去行他们喜欢做的东西，千万不要去约束他们。
Is that not what modern day psychiatrists and psychologists tell us? They say, let your children do whatever they want and never limit or restrict them.
撒母耳记三章十二节告诉我们，因这以利没有好好的管教他的孩子，所以神审判他们。
First Samuel 3:12-13 tells us, because Eli did not discipline his children, God was about to judge his household.
十三节说，我曾告诉他必永远降罚与他的家，因他知道儿子作孽，自遭咒诅，却不禁止他们。
I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God and he did not restrain them.
你可以说，哦，这个是他们在作孽，是这个他们是因为做祭司没有做好，这个是因此这献祭的时候所犯的罪。
You could argue that, oh no, this is got to do with Eli and his sons not being good priests.
可是在撒母耳记下，我们看见大卫王也是犯同样的错误。
But later on in 2 Samuel, we'll see that King David also fell foul of the same sin.
大卫王是一个非常伟大的王。
David was obviously a great king.
不过他虽然是一个非常伟大的王，是一个很勇猛的战士，不过在家里他却没有好好的管好他的孩子。
And while he was a great king and a fierce general, at home he did not discipline his children.
你们有机会的话，可以去读撒母耳记下十三章，这里讲大卫王听见这事就甚发怒。
You can go read for yourself in 2 Samuel chapter 13. Verse 21 says, When King David heard of all these things, he was very angry.
这些事是什么？
What are these things?
他的大儿子强奸了他的小女儿。
His eldest son raped his youngest daughter.
他听见了只是发怒，没有去管教他的大儿子。
And he was only described as being very angry when he heard it. He didn't actually do anything.
他的小女儿的哥哥就是亚沙龙。
His daughter's brother is Absalom.
亚沙龙去杀了他的哥哥。
Absalom went and killed his brother.
后来亚沙龙也因着大卫没有好好的管教他，他竟然想要夺取这一个王位。
And because Absalom was not disciplined by David, he then rose up to try and usurp David's throne.
撒母耳记下第十五章说，这个亚沙龙他们要夺取王位的时候，大卫就必须要逃走。
2 Samuel 15 tells us that because Absalom was trying to usurp the throne, David and his servants had to flee.
所以一个好的带领人必须首先管理好自己的家，这个是非常重要的。
A good leader needs to manage his household well.
这一个事业等等的不重要。
Career is less important.
大卫他的事业非常的成功。
David's career was extremely successful.
以利的事业非常的成功。
Eli's career was successful.
一个是王，另外一个是大祭司。
One was a king, one was a high priest.
所以无论是所谓属世的这个事业，或者是属灵的事业，这一切都不重要。最重要的是有没有好好的管理好自己的家。
These things do not matter. What's important is, are we managing our households well?
如果你是弟兄的话，我们必须要好好的听主的话。
If you are a man, are you listening to God's word?
如果你是姐妹的话，好好的帮助你的丈夫来服从主的话。
Sisters, are you helping your husbands to obey God's word?
如果你是这单身的姐妹，你也知道应该怎样去寻找一个好的伴侣。
Singles, you now have a guide for you to find a godly man.
这个真的是非常重要，因为如果我们是花了一生人的时间去追求我们的事业等等的，到头来还是一场空。
It is so important because we can spend our whole lives pursuing a career, but come home to an empty hole.
最终的，当我们老的时候，回头一看的时候，我们可能会后悔。哎呀，我应该这样做，我应该那样做。现在就好好的去服从主的话。
And you do not want to, at the end of the day, look back and see that, and regret, and tell yourselves, I should have done this better.
大卫他没有好好的管教自己的孩子，结果整个家庭都是混乱，不只是混乱，而且你杀我，我杀你。
Because David did not manage his household well, his entire family was in strife, killing one another.
所以一个好的带领人的模式，首先必须要祷告，第二他必须要好好的管理自己的家，第三他要侍奉。
The leader's method is to pray, it is to manage his household well, and finally it is to serve.
在路加福音二十二章二十六节已经告诉我们，你们不可这样，你们里头为大的倒要像年幼的，为首领的倒要像服侍人的。
Luke 22:26 says, But not so with you. Rather, let the greatest among you become as the youngest, and the leader as the one who serves.
一个好的带领人的模式，他必须要做决定。
The leader needs to be making decisions.
可是一个好的带领人要怎样来做决定呢？
How does a good leader make good decisions?
当然，首先他必须要认识神的话，认识神的教导。
Of course, the basis of any good decision is that he needs to understand God's word and follow his teaching.
他也需要跟从耶和华所做的，箴言十六章三节，要交托耶和华，你所谋的就必成立。
He needs to commit his work to the Lord, as Proverbs 16:3 says, "Commit your work to the Lord, and your plans will be established."
我们所做的决定应该是符合圣经的，所以你必须要懂圣经写的是什么。
Our decisions and our actions need to be influenced and guided by God's word, and so we need to know what God's word is.
当然，同时间我们不是完全的什么事我们都懂，我们不是全知的，所以我们必须要听其他人的劝告。
But of course, we are not all-knowing, and sometimes we need to listen to the wisdom of others.
所以箴言十五章二十二节说，不先商议，所谋无效；谋事众多，所谋乃成。
Proverbs 15:22 says, "Without counsel, plans fail; but with many advisers, they succeed."
当然，我们的这个谋士是什么？就是教会的弟兄姐妹，在主内比较成熟的基督徒，你应该去找他们商议应该怎么做。你需要做有一个受教的心。
But we need to be discerning about who these advisors are, and here, we're talking about people who are more advanced in years, people who have a bit more experience in the church and who are spiritual, in order to be guides for us. And of course, we need to have teachable hearts to listen to that advice.
带领人的模式除了祷告，要管理好自己的家，要侍奉，要做决定，也必须要沟通。
The leader needs to pray, manage their household, serve, make decisions, and also communicate.
沟通非常重要。
Communication is very important.
一个好的带领人，他带领人走的方向，可是他没有好好的沟通，要人怎样跟随他呢？
A leader might want to lead his people in a certain direction, but if he is not communicating, how will they know?
箴言十五章一节到两节。回答柔和，使怒消退；言语暴怨暴戾，触动怒气。智慧人的舌散发智慧，愚昧人的口吐出愚昧。
Proverbs 15:1-2 says, "A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. The tongue of the wise commends knowledge, but the mouth of fools pour out folly."
所以好的带领人要懂得好好的沟通。
A good leader needs to communicate well.
这个怎样沟通，圣经有许多的经文告诉我们。
The Bible is full of instruction on how we can communicate well.
以弗所书四章二十九节，污秽的言语一句不可出口，只要随时说造就人的好话，叫听见的人得益处。
For example, Ephesians 4:29, let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up as fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear.
这个不只是我给弟兄姐妹在教会里怎样的沟通，而是指你在家中也是要有同样的这一种说法。
This is not an instruction just for the church. It is an instruction for all of your communication, even in the home.
记得我们刚才说一个好的带领人，他的生命是要有这个正直，言行举止要一致的，无论是在家中或者是在教会，必须要一致。
Remember, we said just now that the leader needs to have integrity, and that means whether in an environment where others are watching him or at home in his own realm.He needs to be behaving in the right way.
如果一个人在教会是非常的柔和谦卑啊，这个是假谦卑，可是在家里就是非常暴躁，讲话是完全不客气的，乱发脾气，这样就不是一个正直的人。
If like our example just now, where we said a person is on the surface very kind and gracious and gentle in front of others, but he goes home and he's got a bad temper, and that's just not a person with integrity.
所以要怎么样做一个好的带领人？圣经给我们非常清楚的教导。
How do you be a good leader? The Bible is clear on how we can do that.
当然我们知道神所赐给教会的牧师是为了要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体，只等到我们众人在真道上同归于一，认识神的儿子，得以长大成人，满有基督成长的身量。
The objective of all of this, as Ephesians 4:11-13 tells us, that it is to equip the saintsUntil we all attain to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ.
神赐给教会的长老是为了带领个人更加的像基督，更加的成熟成长。
God has given the church elders for the very purpose of making them more mature in Christ.
所以教会的带领人就是长老。
The church leaders are the elders.
在家中的带领人就是丈夫。
And the leaders at home are the husbands.
带领人的工作必须是要符合圣经的。
And the work of the leader needs to align with the gospel, with the Bible.
当然我们如果要讲到非常的详细的细节，要如何的去做，这个每一个家庭有不同的做法。
Now, if you want to know the how is this done in various settings, there are different ways.
这里所讲的是讲一个人的品格，而不是应该怎样有一个第一点，第二还是第一步，第二步，第三步，他应该这样做，他应该这样做，这个是每一个家庭不一样的。
But the point.Of the Bible is to give us the principles of leadership. How it actually happens in the families, in individual families, may be different.
我们千万不要用这个属世的观点去看。
We cannot look at things from an earthly perspective.
圣经没有说丈夫姐妹必须要求丈夫赚这么多钱才算是好的带领人。圣经没有讲这些。
The Bible doesn't tell us that, oh, a good leader, sisters, you need to look out for someone who earns good money.
或者是他在工作的时候他在这个工作的场合，他必须要有这样的这个角色才叫做一个好的带领人。
Or it doesn't tell us that, oh, you need to look for someone who is good at his work.
或者是他回到家中，他必须要做什么东西？这些圣经没有给我们很详细的这个形容。
It doesn't give us specifics as to what a good leader needs to do. For example, when he gets home from work.
啊，这个好的带领人回到家，我的丈夫必须要陪我的孩子读书。圣经没有这么说。
It doesn't say, oh, when my husband gets back, he needs to help my children with his or her work. It doesn't say that.
或者是我的太太应该是这样的，我的丈夫应该是那样的。 这一些圣经如果没有讲的话，我们就不要去来拿来做争论。
The Bible doesn't give us specifics on what activities the leader or our wives or husbands have to do.
所以我们今天看的这个带领人的委任，还有他的品格，还有他的模式。如果是我们看见这个带领人真的有这样的品格，他是一个谦卑的人，他是一个正直的人，他是一个有勇气的人，这个就是一个好的带领人。
The Bible gives us the principles of a good leader, and as we've seen, what the leader's mandate is, how his manner should be, and what his method looks like.
如果他是一个有祷告的人，他是一个好好管理家中的人，他是一个侍奉的人，他怎样去侍奉，这个不重要。
If he is a man who prays, he is a man who serves, we don't have to specify how he prays or how he serves.
只要的就是他有祷告吗？他有跟随神的话吗？他有好好的管理自己的家？根据神的话，也就是说他必须要去管教他的孩子。
The important thing is that he lives a life that is obedient to God's word, and in the home he disciplines his children.
让我们做一个结束的祷告。
Let's close in prayer. Our Father, we thank you for giving us a better understanding, Lord, of the leadership that you have called us to in the various spheres of our lives. We pray that, Lord, you will help us to see that all Christians are called to some form of leadership, Lord, as you have given us the Great Commission, so we are to lead the nations to become your disciples. We pray that even in our own spheres of influence with our friends, our families, we would take on that leadership role. For others, Lord, who are leaders in their homes, we pray that, Lord, you will grant us wisdom in leading. We pray that, Lord, our leadership will be led by your word and not our own will. We pray, Lord, that you will also be with the leaders in this church, Lord, that they will be there to do your will and not our own. And Father, may you be glorified in all the work that we do as leaders. 亲爱的天父，感谢你赐予我们你的话语，求你赐予我们愿意受教的心，学习顺服你的话，奉主耶稣基督的名求，阿们。
In response to the message, let us sing, I am resolved.